Good morning, students. In this chapter, Indigo, so far we come to know Gandhiji was attending the annual convent of Indian National Congress. There, the peasant Rajkumar Shukla came. His wish was to make Gandhiji visit Champaran. Why? Just because of the Indigo sharecropping arrangement. All the peasants of India, of Champaran, were fed up by this arrangement. We have studied what Indigo sharecropping arrangement is. After that, Gandhiji had many appointments, but Rajkumar Shukla did not leave Gandhi's side. From Lucknow to Kanpur, from Kanpur to Ahmedabad, from Ahmedabad to Calcutta. He did not leave Gandhi's side. Gandhiji got impressed and went with him to Patna. There in Patna, they went to the house of Rajendra Prasad. Rajendra Prasad was later, he became the president of Congress Party and of India. There Gandhiji got treatment like a poor peasant. He also faced untouchability. He was not allowed to take water from the well, thinking that a single drop from his hand would pollute the entire source. Thereafter, Gandhiji had certain plans. Before reaching or going directly to Champaran, he decided to go to Muzaffarpur, visit Muzaffarpur, in order to collect more information related to Indigo sharecropping arrangement, which Rajkumar Shukla was incapable of providing. When Gandhiji reached Muzaffarpur, there all the peasants who came to know about him, as well as lawyers of that area came. They told Gandhiji, lawyers gave the complete detail of the case to Gandhiji and also told the fee they were charging from the peasants. At this, Gandhiji became angry. He chided them for collecting big fees and also asked them that the peasant should stop going to law court just because it was a torture for them. First of all, they were already exploited by British landlords, and if they file the case in the court, they are exploited by paying heavy fees to the local lawyers. So far we come to know. Let's continue with the chapter now. We are on page number 48, last para. Most of the arable land. Arable land means land capable of cultivation. Most of the arable land in the Champaran district was divided into large estates owned by Englishmen and worked by Indian tenants. In Champaran, what happened? What was the rule in Champaran? Most of the land capable of cultivation was divided into large estates, and the owner of those land were British landlords, Englishmen. The chief commercial crop was indigo there. In Champaran, the chief commercial crop was jisko sell karke zyada se zyada paise milte hain. So, chief commercial crop at that time was indigo. The landlords compelled all the tenants to plant 3/20 or 15% of their holdings with indigo and surrender the entire indigo harvest as rent. This was done by long-term contract. This I have already told you, indigo share, what is indigo sharecropping arrangement. According to an old arrangement, the peasants of Champaran were compelled to plant indigo on 15% of their land एंड देयर आफ्टर दे हैड टू गिव द एंटायर इंडिगो हार्वेस्ट एज रेंट एंड दिस वॉज डन बाय अ लॉन्ग टर्म कॉन्ट्रैक्ट. Actually, the problem was the indigo commercial, the chief commercial crop was indigo. And if they give indigo to British planters, they will sell the crop and take maximum benefit, which the peasants were incapable of getting. Presently, the landlords learned that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. They thereupon obtained arrangements from the sharecroppers to pay them compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. Presently, the landlords came to know, learn means they came to know that Germany had developed synthetic indigo. When British landlords came to know that Germany had developed synthetic indigo, artificial indigo, they thereupon obtain arrangements from the sharecroppers to pay compensation for being released from the 15% arrangement. What happened when Gandhiji reached Muzaffarpur? When Gandhiji reached Muzaffarpur, a new problem came in front of the peasants. They had been caught in the web of or they had been burdened by the arrangement of indigo sharecropping for years. But now, when the British planters were able to get synthetic indigo from Germany, they obviously would get it on cheap rates. So, applying all their wits, they offered British Indian planters that if they wanted to be free from the arrangement of 15%, they would have to pay something for compensation. The sharecropping arrangement was irksome. Irksome is irritating, annoying to the peasants, and many signed willingly. They signed willingly. It means they became ready that they were able to surrender the entire harvest to. Sorry, not entire harvest. They were ready to get themselves free from 15% sharecropping arrangement. For that, they were ready to pay compensation. So many peasants signed willingly. Those who resisted, those who went against it, those who opposed it, engaged lawyers. Some peasants signed willingly as they wanted to get free from irritating indigo sharecropping arrangement. But some opposed giving any compensation to landlords. So they engaged lawyers, the landlords hired thugs. Meanwhile, the information about synthetic indigo reached the illiterate peasants who had signed and they wanted their money back. Now the illiterate peasants, the peasants who innocently signed in order to get release from 15% of arrangement, now they got the information that British planters were able to get synthetic indigo on cheap rates from Germany. Now they got the idea what actually landlords were planning to do. So they wanted their money back. They stated that we do not want to be free from indigo sharecropping arrangement. We just want our money back. At this point, Gandhi arrived in Champaran. At that crucial point, Gandhiji reached in Champaran. Before reaching Champaran, he collected remaining information related to this case, visiting Muzaffarpur. He began by trying to get the facts. Gandhiji started his work in order to get more information, in order to get more facts, collect more facts. First of all, he visited the secretary of the British Landlords Association. After reaching Champaran, Gandhiji visited two officials. First of all, he met the secretary of BLA. BLA stands for British Landlords Association. The secretary told him that they could give no information to an outsider. Gandhi answered that he was no outsider. It was an excuse made by the secretary of the British Landlord Association. He denied to give any information to Gandhiji, stating that he was an outsider. To this, Gandhiji answered that he was no outsider. Next, Gandhi, after meeting the secretary of British Landlord Association, Gandhiji called on the British official commissioner at the Tirhut division in which the Champaran district lay. Gandhiji met the British official commissioner, the commissioner of Tirhut division in which the Champaran district lay. The commissioner, Gandhi reports, proceeded to bully. Bully is threaten me and advised me forthwith. Forthwith means immediately to leave Tirhut. When Gandhiji met the commissioner of Tirhut division, the commissioner started threatening him and also advised him to leave Tirhut at once. Now question can be asked, what was the result of Gandhiji's meeting with the officials of what were the efforts done by Gandhiji after reaching Champaran to collect more facts? Another question can be asked, what was the result of Gandhiji's meeting with the secretary of BLA and the commissioner of Tirhut division? Students, as one marks question can be asked, not only can be, will be asked. So you need to know every detail related to chapter. You must recall whom did Gandhiji meet, what was the reply. Because extract based question will be asked on the basis of the chapters related to flamingo. So you must pay attention to every word, every detail. Thereafter, Gandhi did not leave. When Gandhiji was threatened to leave Tirhut by the commissioner, Gandhiji did not leave. Instead of leaving, he proceeded, he forwarded to Motihari. Motihari was the capital of Champaran. He moved towards the capital of Champaran. Several lawyers accompanied him, gave him a company at the railway station. A vast multitude greeted Gandhi, welcomed Gandhi. He went to a house and, using it as headquarters, continued to his investigation. A report came in that a peasant had been maltreated in a nearby village. When Gandhiji was staying in Motihari, which was the capital of Champaran, many lawyers welcomed him at railway station. A vast multitude greeted, a large number of people welcomed Gandhi. At Motihari, Gandhiji stayed in a house. He used that house as a headquarter and continued his investigations from there. When Gandhiji was staying there, he got a report that a peasant had been maltreated in a nearby village. Gandhi decided to go and see the next morning. When Gandhiji got the news that a peasant had been maltreated, he decided to go and meet that peasant in order to know what his condition was, as well as to collect information what happened with him. But the next morning, he started out on the back of an elephant. The next morning, he started his journey sitting on the back of the elephant. He had not proceeded far. He had not continued far when the police superintendent's messenger overtook him and ordered him to return to town. Gandhiji had not proceeded far going towards the house, towards the village where a peasant had been maltreated. Then there the messenger of police superintendent came and ordered him to return to town. Town here stands for Motihari. Town in his carriage. This is the next page, page number 50. Gandhi complied. Complied means obeyed. As the messenger of police superintendent asked him to go in his carriage, Gandhiji agreed for that. The messenger drove Gandhi home, where he served him with an official. Served him means provided him with an official notice to quit Champaran immediately. When the messenger and Gandhiji reached the home, the messenger provided Gandhiji an official notice in which Gandhiji was asked to leave Champaran immediately. Immediately ke liye we have used another word, that is forthwith. Gandhi signed a receipt for the notice and wrote on it that he would disobey the order. Gandhiji signed the notice that he had read it, but also wrote that he would disobey the order. In consequence means as a result, Gandhi received a summons to appear in court the next day. Summon is official notice. Gandhiji got official call to be present in the court next day as a result of disobeying the order. But when he got the summon, all night Gandhi remained awake. The whole night Gandhiji could not sleep. The whole night when Gandhiji got an official notice to be present in the court, a case was filed against him of disobeying the order. The whole night he made certain plans. All night Gandhi remained awake. He telegraphed Rajendra Prasad to come from Bihar with influential friends. He sent instructions to the ashram. He wired a full report to the viceroy. First thing, he did three things that night. Number one, he telegraphed Rajendra Prasad and asked him to come from Bihar with his influential friends. Number two, he sent instructions to the ashram Sevagram. And number three, he wired a full report to the viceroy. Thereafter, morning found the town of Motihari black with peasants. They did not know Gandhi's record in South Africa. They had merely heard that a Mahatma who wanted to help them was in trouble with the authorities. Their spontaneous demonstration in thousands around the courthouse was the beginning of their liberation from fear of the British. Next morning, when Gandhiji was to present at Motihari court, he found that thousands of peasants had collected at Motihari court. Why did they collect there? Although they did not know any record of Gandhiji's efforts done at South Africa, but they merely come to know that a Mahatma, a great man, who wanted to help them, was in trouble because of authorities. So their continuous demonstration in thousands around the courthouse was just the beginning of liberation from the fear of the British. That was the beginning to get free from the fear of British. That was the first time when a number of peasants or number of people collected in support of someone against the Britishers. Thereafter, the officials felt powerless without Gandhi's cooperation. He helped them regulate the crowd. He was polite and friendly. He was giving them concrete proof that the officials felt powerless without Gandhi's cooperation. When officials sought Gandhiji's help to regulate the crowd, regulate means control the crowd. Gandhiji helped them control the crowd. He was polite and friendly. He was giving them concrete proof, solid proof, them stands for Britishers, that their might stands for power, strength, hitherto means thereupon, dreaded and unquestioned, could be challenged by Indian. In this particular paragraph, one question can be asked, why did Gandhiji control the crowd? Why did officials felt powerless? What did Gandhi do? When the officials, obviously they were less in number and peasants were thousands in number, it became hard for the officials to control the crowd. So they had to sought help of Gandhiji. Gandhiji helped them regulate the crowd, but he was polite and friendly, but side by side he kept giving the Britishers a concrete proof. What proof did he provide them? That their strength, hitherto means so far, their strength, which was dreading, which was fearful and unquestioned by anyone, could be challenged by Indians. Gandhiji provided or showed solid proof to the Britishers that their power in the world, which was never challenged by anyone. Britishers, wherever they went, they kept on conquering, or they settled their colonies and all that, no? They kept on conquering the countries. But here Gandhiji showed them the power of Indians. He showed them that Britishers' power, which was unquestioned, unchallenged by anyone, now it could be challenged by Indians. He provided them solid proof. The government was baffled. The British government was baffled by seeing all this. The prosecutor requested the judge to postpone the trial. The public prosecutor, the public lawyer requested the judge to postpone the trial. Why? Apparently, means clearly, the authorities wish to consult their superiors. Obviously, the authorities wanted to consult their superiors. That's why they wanted to postpone the trial. They wanted to consult their superiors so that they come to know what could be done in that situation. Gandhi protested against the delay. When Gandhiji came to know that prosecutor was trying to postpone the trial, Gandhiji protested against that. When the proceedings continue, at that time, he read a statement. He stands for Gandhiji. It's quite an important paragraph. Gandhiji read a statement pleading guilty. When Gandhiji was to present in the court, he stated it clearly that he was guilty. He was guilty of disobeying the order. But he also presented his point of view, his side. He was involved. He told the court in a conflict of duties. On the one hand, not to set a bad example as a lawbreaker. On the other hand, to render the humanitarian and national service for which he had come. He disregarded the order to leave, not for want of request for lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience, he asked the penalty to. It's quite an important paragraph. I just told this thing. When Gandhiji was asked why he did not obey the order, he clearly admitted that he was guilty of disobeying the order. But he presented his point of view that he was involved in a conflict of duties. He was involved in a conflict of duties whether to perform this duty or that one. Which duties were in front of him? On one hand, he did not want to set a bad example by breaking the law. ठीक है? If he breaks the law, he would set a bad example in front of the people of India, people of Champaran. On the other hand, to render means to provide the humanitarian and national service for which he had come. There were two duties in front of him. First was to obey the order and not to present a bad example by disobeying the order. But on the other side, he had the duty to serve the humanitarian and national service, to provide his humanitarian and national service, means to help the poor sharecroppers of Champaran for which he had come. He had two options: whether to disobey the order or to break the heart and faith of the people of Champaran. He disregarded the order to leave. So in that situation, he thought it would be better to disregard the order to leave Champaran. So he disobeyed the order, not for want of respect for lawful authority. He did not disobey the order for the lawful authority, but in obedience to the higher law of our being, the voice of conscience, he asked the penalty due. Gandhiji stated it clearly. He disobeyed the order to leave Champaran because he listened to his voice of conscience, the law of our being, our existence. That is, he asked the penalty due. At that time, उन्होंने कहा कि मैंने अपनी अंतरात्मा की आवाज़ सुनी, और भाई मैंने अंतरात्मा की आवाज़ सुनी जो हमारी एग्जिस्टेंस, हमारे ये जो ह्यूमन लॉ है इससे ऊपर का लॉ है और हमारी एग्जिस्टेंस का लॉ है. ही वॉज रेडी टू टेक द पेनल्टी, पे द पेनल्टी. ही थैंक यू बेटा.